MedCram.com.
Welcome to another MedCram video. We're going to talk about what's happened to monkeypox. Here is data from the state of Washington looking at the total weekly case counts. And this goes back to June of 2022. And as you can see here, it goes up to as high as a count of 76 in late July of 2022 and comes down to almost non-existent here as far as we can go here to the week of February 5th, 2023. This is in the state of Washington. And the good news is that what's going on in Washington is actually going on in the rest of the country and even around the world is that monkeypox cases are decreasing. And the question is what happened? Why did these cases go down? And for those of you who want some more information, I highly recommend going back and watching our Monkeypox Explained Clearly series, where we talk about the virus, how it spreads, and also the vaccines that were available before and currently available. So a quick summary is this is a virus that spreads through contact, particularly in the genital area in this typical outbreak, and also concentrated in men who have sex with men. We can see here the different areas of the country where this was an issue. For instance, this very dark county here on the map in the state of Washington is King County, where the majority of the cases were, as you can see, 76.3%. We can look at the demographics in this sort of situation. We can see here that the overwhelming majority were male and a minority were female, only about 2.4% of cases. You can see here that white was the race that was most commonly seen. And you can also see in terms of age where we were seeing most of the symptom onset in the 25 to 34 year old age group. We can click on vaccinations, and we'll see here that in the state of Washington, almost north of 30,000 cumulative doses of vaccines were given. But I'm curious as to exactly what it was that caused this outbreak to come down. There's the vaccination aspect of it, but the amount of vaccinations only being about 30,000 in a huge population, some would argue actually might be reduced because there's a high-risk group that may be smaller in population. And so the question of whether the vaccines by themselves caused the epidemic to go down is an interesting one. We saw in COVID, where we had waves of SARS-CoV-2 infections well before vaccines were available, would go up and down on their own, almost as if it was more behavior modification that seemed to be the primary factor. So as cases were going up, people would make modifications. They would not go out as much, or they would be more careful in terms of what they were doing. And one has to wonder whether or not this is what happened. There was an interesting article published in the New York Times titled, "What Happened to Monkeypox and Why Cases Suddenly Began to Decline." There's a number of theories that they look at. It was in October or November of 2022, and you can clearly see the daily average monkeypox cases in the United States were on the decline. Their theories are interesting. They say that four factors explain monkeypox's decline. First, vaccines help slow the virus spread. Certainly, that could possibly be it, but I don't think that explains all of it. Second, they say, gay and bisexual men reduced activities, such as sex with multiple partners, that spread the virus more quickly. The third reason is Pride Month effect, and they say that beyond the parades and rallies, some parties and other festivities involved casual sex, which of course, through contact, which happens during sex, that is going to spread the monkeypox virus. As the celebrations dwindled, so did the increased potential for monkeypox to spread. And finally, the virus simply burned out. Monkeypox mainly spreads through close contact, making it harder to transmit than a pathogen that is primarily airborne, like coronavirus. Here you can see the data on the CDC website looking at U.S. monkeypox case trends reported, and you can see it's almost non-existent, fortunately. If we want to look on a global scale, we can go to the WHO website, which calls it Mpox, in parentheses monkeypox, for 2022. You can see here that there are over 85,000 confirmed cases globally, 93 deaths, and 110 countries reporting cases. So if we scroll down here, we can see the global situation. The peak was in the summer of 2022, just before August. And we are now down to a very low level, although there does seem to be a little bit there at the bottom with the different colors denoting the different regions. So you can see that most of this is in the region of the Americas. If we look at deaths, Again, most of this appears to be in the African and specifically the region of the Americas. That would be here in the United States, Mexico, Canada, and South America as well. In the African region, these are not to scale, so this is a scale of 200 in the African region. Eastern Mediterranean, a scale of 10. European, a scale of 2,000. Region of the Americas, 4,000, which is where the majority of the cases have been. And then we have the Southeast Asia region with a scale of 6, and the Western Pacific region with a scale of 20. There's other things we can look at here in terms of deaths. Not many deaths in the African region. Not many at all in the Eastern Mediterranean region. 2 in the European, up to 8, and several more here in the region of the Americas, and then only 1 in the South Asian. So we can see here that the majority of the outbreak was the region of the Americas, which is a large populous region. If we look at the top 10 countries, here we see Brazil with a scale here of up to 1,000, Canada with 150 at its peak, Colombia with 400, France with 500, Germany with about 500, Mexico with about 350, Peru with about 300 to 400, Spain 1,200, the United Kingdom 400, and the United States of America about 3,000. If we look at global cases once more, we can see, however, that the trend is on the way down. And of course, we'll put a link to this article and also the other articles in this video in the description below. If we go to the European Center for Disease Prevention and Control, essentially the CDC of Europe, they say here, Mpox, formerly named monkeypox. So just be aware of that if you want to appear to be up to date. They have the updates and the global update, and then of course the risk assessment, which I think is important here. What is the risk assessment currently in Europe regarding Mpox? Based on the updated risk assessment, they say, and the declining number of new cases in the European region, although they did find some more this week in the Balkans, the overall risk of Mpox infection is assessed as moderate for men who have sex with men and low for the broader population in the EU countries. So it's possible to get it, even not a man who has sex with men, but it's lower. The weekly number of Mpox cases reported in the EU peaked in July of 2022, and since then, a steady declining trend has been observed, reaching a plateau with very low numbers since week 52. That's at the end of 2022. Multiple factors have probably contributed to the decline of this, and let's see what they say here. Community engagement. I think that's important to understand. Early on, there was a hesitancy to say something about the group that was most at risk for contracting this, but I believe that they honestly spoke about risk factors and the problems with spreading this disease. They say here that there was increasing immunity, probably both from the vaccine and also from natural immunity, in those most affected population groups. And there was a decrease in the number of large cultural and social events frequented by the main risk groups for this outbreak after the summer. And I think that is also really important. Even in the COVID pandemic, why we started to see waves coming down even before vaccines were available, which tells you that the waves would come and go based on human behavior or the properties of the virus itself. I think that actually human behavior had a lot to do with these waves coming down on their own. They say options for EU and EEA countries to respond to Mpox cases include raising awareness among healthcare professionals. So I think it's important that we all be able to recognize what Mpox or monkeypox looks like, supporting sexual health services and continue case detection, contact tracing, and management of cases, continuing to offer testing for orthopox virus, vaccination strategies, and continuing risk communication and community engagement despite the decreasing number of cases. So we don't want to be complacent because those numbers are going down. We want to be vigilant in terms of picking those cases up. So I just want to make sure that we did close out that discussion that we've had on monkeypox. I highly recommend you go back and look at our series on Monkeypox Explained Clearly. You can see that on YouTube or go to our website and sign up. We have plenty of other courses that you can get, some of which have continuing medical education credits for it, to get a full picture of what monkeypox looks like and some of the treatment options and vaccine options too. And while we do cover things that are emerging, we also want to cover things when there is a success and when we see these numbers going down, because that is very reassuring. Of course, we will cover it if we start to see any change. Appreciate your time. Thanks for joining us. Don't forget to subscribe, turn on notifications, leave us a comment about what you think might be the reason why these waves go up and down. And don't forget to join us at medcram.com.